Yeah, screw waiting.
Ooh, I found a secret!
Did you?
Without even... Yeah, I went through that wall. Look at that shit!
I just thought you fucking straight up disappeared.
You thought the game just glitched up?
Yeah.
Alright.
Wouldn't be the first time while a game is glitched up like that.
This one is actually also pretty easy. It's literally just the second one, but with more things to jump over.
Oh,
why did you do that?
Because I know that there's one that you have to jump through, but... That was all instinct.
That was all instinct.
That was all instinct.
I think you need to activate your Ultra Instinct so that you don't do that shit anymore.
No, what all do you know about Ultra Instinct?
Goku turns blue?
No. That's actually not true.
He gets wind around him?
Kind of, yeah.
Doesn't he get blue hair? I thought he got blue hair.
No.
What color hair does he get?
When he's fully Ultra Instinct, it turns white. Yeah, it goes white.
That's probably what I was just...
Yeah. You're thinking of, Super Saiyan Blue.
No, I was probably thinking of, like, weird lighting that was on the white hair that made it look like a faded blue.
Well, no,
honestly.
The one that, the video that I showed you about it, his hair was black, but he just had, like, a blue aura around
him. Oh,
the,
maybe that's what I'm remembering.
That's what, yeah.
Maybe that's what I'm he's got Spidey senses.
Yes.
And that's his powers.
Pretty wow.
He's got Spidey senses.
Yeah.
That's pretty much it. So, when people ask me who would win in a fight, Goku or Spider-Man, I would say, well, it's a pretty close margin.
Not really, no.
You know I'm just making epic jocks, dude.
I know you are.
I'm making
the
jocks.
I love Spidey, but, I don't think he's winning that fight.
Spidey's epic.
Man, Spider-Man can knock out a dinosaur in one punch. That's canon.
Can One Punch Man knock out a dinosaur in one punch? What's that other one that everyone likes now?
My Hero Academia?
No. Well, I mean, yes, a lot of people like that too. I mean, that's literally just like... anime superheroes. That's literally
that's
what it is.
That's exactly what it is.
Which is, I mean, that's an
it
epic
literally
premise.
It has the name in it.
Yeah. I think that's an epic premise. Oh yeah, sorry, patented game. Where do you think the item box is, Jordan?
Right there. No.
Right where?
Right. Yeah, no, right
there?
Oh, no.
No?
I was thinking right near where I was, because it has a little dip.
Oh. Oh shit. Didn't even think of that. We'll have to keep an eye out for that.
I mean, it's probably not.
I don't know, it's just a fun little game we can do.
Yeah.
It's fine, and I'm gone. Because I was drinking a nice coffee.
Yeah.
Shit!
You were drinking a nice, fresh Tim Hortons iced coffee, only at Tim Hortons.
Yeah, dude. Did you hear that their...
No.
...company rating or whatever fell down a lot from
what?
Last year? Because remember all that controversy about people like getting less benefits or something on their employments?
Oh, yeah.
And now they went down from like number four to like number 50. Like in 1 year over that.
Jesus.
Oh, well.
That's a big drop.
Well, that's what happens when you make people angry.
Yeah, but the only reason why they did the drop like that is because the minimum wage raised.
Right.
So it's like 15 an hour or something like that.
Yeah.
So they drop like the benefits and stuff.
But,
so it's like one or the other.
But Jordan, that big company has a bajillion dollars.
Yeah.
So why can't they continue to shoulder my constant requests and demands?
Because you don't get to be a successful company, Will, by not stepping on toes.
But Jordan, are you trying to tell me that in order for a corporation to make lots of money, it needed to cut corners somewhere along the way so that it makes lots of money?
I mean, like, they'd still have money, it's just they don't like losing money.
I hate...
It's just the way business works.
I can't believe this corporation is acting like a corporation.
Yeah.
Who do they think they are? A corporation?
Yeah. I mean, look, companies don't like being in the red.
It's true.
But you can still function in the red, it's just not a great thing when you're a multi-million-dollar company.
Fair enough.
Actually, if you're in the red, that's probably a sign that, you know, the end's coming.
Potentially. Because there's kind of a two-faceted thing to it, because then, I mean, like, then you start losing, like, the shareholder faith and shit like that. And then more people could duck out from that.
It's only a problem when you're in the deep red. So, like, you're really losing money.
Yeah, exactly. Look at that, I picked you up automatically. How cool is that?
Coming up.
That's real cool.
I got you some goodies.
Yay!
Look at this shit. Let's see what else there is.
Disappointment.
Whoa, where are we going?
I guarantee
I don't know.
Right
here. Oh. How do we get there?
God damn it, Will. You talking... You know what? Actually, just like this month, I've looked up the Zaboomafoo food theme.
That's awesome.
Just because, like, it was like late at night, too.
Where we going? I don't know. How do we get there? Come on, let's go. Ah!
Shit.
You gotta continue. You gotta hit the button. Look, it's Nucleus.
You know what? I feel like that's a show that they could bring back.
Zaboomafoo? They sort of did. Sort of. The Kratt brothers came back with another show aimed at children that was supposed to teach them about animals.
Yeah, what was it called?
Wild Kratts.
No, I don't like that as much. It should have just straight up been Zaboomafoo again.
I mean, yeah, I don't know. I don't think, when it comes to shit like that, you gotta understand that a lot of that is molded by your nostalgia. And that it was kind of lightning in a bottle as well. Like,
yeah.
you know they wouldn't be able to recreate the charm and success of the original.
No, but I think that it could still be something for the kids.
I don't think.
No?
I can already let you know that every single executive that would be helming that project would not allow Zaboomafoo to be a puppet. He'd have to be CG.
But CG and TV... Like, in, like... Netflix is one thing,
mm-hmm.
because they actually can make a budget for CG, but like just regular TV stations, CG doesn't really look good.
Oh, I'm not even saying like live action mixed with CG. For all I know, they'd go full CG.
You think so?
Yep.
You think they wouldn't have the brothers in there?
I think they would. They'd just be cartoon CG versions of them voiced by them.
That's
dude,
not
you
good.
Know that's what they do though. You know that's what they do. The Kratt brothers are getting up there in age now.
Yeah.
It's been 20 years.
Well, they can always find someone else.
Yeah, but the Kratt brothers made Zaboomafoo.
They did.
It wouldn't be the same. That's what I'm saying. Like you need the Kratt brothers. You need Zaboomafoo. You need them to be a cute little puppet that rolls around with the animals.
Was it not too long ago that the actual Zaboomafoo died?
Yeah, I think that was a year and a half ago. 2 years ago,
yeah.
I think. Yeah,
that
very
was,
sad.
That was. Kind of upsetting.
It was upsetting, because he was great.
He was part of my childhood, and like actual like edutainment childhood.
Yeah, dude. There are very few good examples of edutainment, but that
well,
was one of them,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, shows, for sure.
There was a part of me at one point that if Animation Cells was ever able to take off, I was actually planning on doing like a children's programming spin-off based on it as well.
Huh.
And, I can't remember the name of the show that I had in mind
for
it.
I did that.
You're fine.
I know, but...
These all connected.
I know, but there's a much better way I could have handled that.
Just it's fine.
Like
just high, far away eyes, dude. Like you're driving on the highway. Just keep an eye on what's far away, not in front of you. And you're fine. There you go. High, far away eyes.
Appreciate it.
No. Yeah, well, you will be, yeah. You're rolling back onto the spot that you locked yourself out of. See? Yeah. All the reds there.
Well, I think that's just for the best. No.
There we go, yeah. Now you're looping back, so now. There you go. There's a spot right there. It still has your two blues. There you go. You should have one more spot here, I think, that has... Yeah, don't. You fucked it up! You panicked! On the corner!
I didn't panic.
Yes, you did. I saw it on your face. I saw it on your jewels.
I just didn't turn right.
I saw it on your jowls. Your shaky jowls.
I am not a pit bull, so
no. Oh, you almost got squished.
I hate that guy down below. Though.
Yeah, I know. You don't like those dudes.
No,
yeah.
They're decks.
That wasn't supposed to happen that way. Oh, there you go. You got it, dude. Look at that.
No!
Look at that shit.
I want the shield!
Here.
Get me over there.
Do you think Sonic is black and blue or golden?
What? Okay, well...
What?
Way to use a dated joke,
yeah,
first of all.
It's fine. You know how it
fucking
is.
Fucking hilarious.
Whoa, that actually worked out really well.
Only because of the double jump.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh!
I'm gonna fly. I don't even need you anymore, Will.
Fine. Take your fucking Beyblade. Go wherever you want.
I can't believe Beyblades is still a thing.
Dude, friggin' Negative Legend released a whole video talking about what happened to Beyblade, like the history of it and shit. It's pretty fascinating. I didn't realize they went into so many different iterations of them. The iterations are separated by how they're built. That's like every incarnation. And if you're actually playing like at Beyblade tournaments and shit, you have to use the same iteration, otherwise it's cheating. Because of the way they're built, some have like inherent advantages over others. You have to get the top to blast into it. You need the top. You need to go all the way back for the Beyblade. You have to get the... If it's one of those breakable ones and you can't break with the spin dash, you need the Beyblade for it. Yeah, there you go. Just ride it close to the ground and it'll go the most of the way.
I don't even have to move.
Yeah. See? There.
So much fun.
You cynical arsehole.
I don't know.
Half the fun of Sonic is just all the cool little set pieces.
Pretty well.
I think that's half
Sometimes
the fun.
It's more like a cutscene than anything else.
Yeah?
Just an over-glorified cutscene.
Well, when you get to play your precious Spider-Man on PS4, you can tell me all about how it's not just a glorified cutscene machine.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I'm really worried that a lot of people are overhyping that too much.
Probably.
Like, I really don't want to come off like I hate the game in any way. I just am really worried for some people who are crazy excited for this game.
I want to see more gameplay footage of it. There's not a whole lot right now. And like, it's all like very set PC right now.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, I really feel like this is going to be like a full like next gen built from the ground up Web of Shadows. And that's okay!
Yeah, Web of Shadows was fun.
But it's set your expectation. Like, people are saying, like, oh, it's made by Naughty Dog. This is not going
this
to be-
This is not Naughty Dog.
Insomniac, sorry. I was just getting them confused. Yeah. If it ends up being that great, that's awesome. And I can't be more happy for people.
Yeah.
Like, this certainly isn't, like, a sour view or anything. It's just... I really want people to not have their hype out of this world and then because
sure.
I feel like if it ends up being what I think it's going to be like, which is still going to be like a solid, like, you know, 7 out of 10 game, 8 out of 10 game.
Look, well, people don't care as long as the web swinging is still good. Have you ever played Spider-Man 2?
Yes, and it was...
The story's not super great. It's just based on the movie and the movie's fine. The voice acting's fucking bad. The fighting's not good. Really, the only good thing about that game is the web swinging.
Yeah. I'm just gonna say this much.
Yeah, sure. You say what you want, man.
One of the most predominant two things from such a lengthy interview that they did these past few days ago about this game were mentioning the special edition that they're letting people pre-order.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that there's no microtransactions. Sorry, three, not two.
I mean, I don't know how the fuck you do a microtransaction on a Spider-Man game, to be honest.
And how big the map is.
Yeah.
That, to me, just personally, screams 7 out of 10, 8 out of 10, cookie-cutter AAA game. That's all I'm saying. Like, the fact that they're not talking up things like the web-slinging and the combat and things like... What do you mean, web-swinging? Web-slinging is the actual term for it.
I guess.
You sling the web, and then you either fight with it, or you...
Oh, I'm dead.
Are you dead? Oh, you are dead.
Yeah.
You...
Because that column over.
You fucked it. You fooked it.
I certainly did. I saw that you were still alive, though, so
I mean,
cool.
I'm fine. I'm shorter than you. So I'll be alive for a little longer. You don't
also,
go that way.
You don't...
Have to oh, you
die.
Do go this way. I always get confused by some of these later levels. When they go right to left instead of left to right. There you go. Whoa! Very nice, dude. Yeah, you were telling me yesterday you're actually going to buy a PS4 for this game.
Yes. Not brand new.
I
will not buy a brand new PS4.
Fair enough.
If I find one used for a good price, because I saw one that most wanted there was like $149.
Yeah.
For a PS4.
Yeah. I would assume like probably like a launch day like basic Model 1 probably. Used is probably running
it
that
said
much.
1TB on it. I doubt it. There's
probably.
No. You think so?
Yeah, why not?
For $149.99.
I'm talking like basic model though.
Okay, yeah.
Like it wouldn't be the pro model, and it
no,
wouldn't be the slim
no.
model. It's probably just the regular yeah. fat model. The
but like
one.
It didn't stay long, no.
No.
But like if I found that, I'd be like, yeah, sure, I'll get that.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't buy brand new. I'm not. The only brand new console I bought is Switch. My brother bought Xbox One, so I don't care for buying Xbox One.
I literally see no reason in buying an Xbox One nowadays.
No.
Quite literally.
Oop. Get me up there.
Yeah, sorry, I forgot that I'm the one controlling this shit now. Literally all you're doing is
I love
jumping.
How you can't die from that.
Nope. Too low. Too low. Alright, alright. He's gonna go from
help
the top
me help
now.
You.
No, too late. Oh,
no, I
you,
hit him.
You got him though, just barely. Okay, he's gonna come up from the top now too, so get ready for this. Yeah, you should have take off to the sides when you do that, because then you get stuck in him, and he kills you.
Well, at least I don't have to worry about dumb shit.
Oh.
Spoke too soon.
That was so awesome. That was like perfect timing.
Who likes Spider-Punk? No
not
one talks
sure.
about him.
Isn't that a pre-order
that
bonus
is a
only?
Pre-order bonus.
So you're gonna have to pre-order the special edition for that. Wait, is it? Oh no, it's
no,
just pre-order.
No, because there's different pre-orders. Well, I'm not getting the special edition. That's way too much fucking money.
I hate that there's pre-order option.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's so retarded.
Yeah, I don't like it either.
This is why I don't buy shit from those systems. Like, I'm sorry, but I shouldn't
yeah.
need a fucking spreadsheet to choose what
and you know what the worst
game I'm
part
buying.
Is?
What?
Those kind of stuff used to just be fucking features in games.
Yeah, I've more than said my piece on that kind of stuff, I guess, at this point. I'm beating the dead horse
yeah.
by continuing to complain. You complain all you want. I've beaten the dead horse on myself complaining about it.
Yay, the best fucking zone ever.